Now, Beck. His story is still being written, but already he's left an indelible mark. Now he's got us waiting for the next chapter. Tonight, we're documenting the final stop of an 18-month tour that began with the release of Odelay. It's something like an eight-man gang.
Devil's handgun in my mind. Thank you for joining us this evening, this afternoon. This is our last performance till next year. I got all my folks behind me. Yeah, y'all like the slow jams. Let me hear you make some noise.
Some noise.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. I made a cold beverage. Glendale, California. Yeah. So I wanna get with you and your sister. I met you, J.C. Penney. I think your name tag said Jenny.
Well, actually, you were born and raised in Los Angeles.
Yeah, right? I was almost born in New York because my parents were living here up in Hell's Kitchen, I guess.
Which is not far
2 weeks.
From
yeah, yeah.
Because this is
kinda, very close.
This is, we're on the parameters of Hell's Kitchen.
I was almost born right over there in that, behind that dumpster. Yeah, I had Yeah, long summer in L.A. I was kind of in a dead-end job. You know, I was like 18 or something.
What were you doing?
And I was doing different odd jobs, delivering stuff, sweeping stuff, you know, whatever, some nondescript jobs. And I decided to come out here to check it out, and I ended up staying for a year or so. So that's where I started performing.
Before you left, you were already playing guitar and...
Yeah. Yeah, I was playing guitar. You know, I was a teenager obsessed with folk music and the blues and, you know, all this. And came here and there was this whole folk scene happening.
Where did you land?
But it was the anti-folk scene.
How would you describe the anti-folk?
It was just very, very aggressive, you know, kind of... folk played with a punk energy, punk rock energy. I mean, it was a lot of. It wasn't as simple as that. You know, it wasn't as you know easily. It's not that easily summed up. It was a lot of people just kind of being free with what they were doing, and you know nobody had anything but an acoustic guitar or microphone, you know, so it's making something out of nothing, I guess.
So I got a little spooked. There's a little man on that camera crane. He was looking in my eyes. Thought he was going to peel my face off. Get him there. Bring him back over here. See, this is what they do on TV to keep you awake. Thought you'd be sitting around all day. There's actually someone's head inside there. If you look very closely. That is the mind of television. Staring into your eyes. That is the incarnated soul. Televised entity. All right, this is called Jackass.
Stale shoes, loose ends,
I'm tying a noose in the back of my mind. If you thought you were making your way to where the puzzles and vagans lay, put it together, it's a strange invitation.
Do you ever stop for a second and just think, geez, lucky guy?
Yeah, there's a lot of luck involved, but there's so much work involved too. I mean, there's a point where you can just say, nah, I'm not gonna work anymore. And, you know, things will stop there. But we just kept working, and you know, we had this idea of what we wanted to do to be able to do. So we just stayed out there. On the road and
sure,
and you know, why do it halfway? We want to put on the best show we can.
Yeah,
but you know, it's never for the glory. It's for the satisfaction of, you know, blowing up a gig. A lot of people are satisfied with the video. Those who aren't satisfied with the video buy an album. And then there's a few who get the album, and then they go to the show, and yeah, that's where.
Yeah. So that's where the
celebration
is.
That's where it's like human beings, yeah. So that's kind of what we live for.
So the best moments for you are when that connection with the audience.
Oh yeah, definitely. I mean, that's where it gets sick, you know. When it's all on a video, when it's all on a record, it's everything's proper, and you know, everyone's minding their manners, but. You know, we'd like to get in there and, you know, cause a commotion. You know, that's the nature of music. That's the way it was meant to be.